Alice. What's the matter, child? You look pale as a ghost.
I can't do it, Nanny.
They don't expect you to sing until after tea. You've got another half an hour to practice.
And relax. Drink a strong cup of herbal tea. It's what I used to do when I was on the boards.
I can't do it. I can't sing.
It's just stage fright. There's nothing to be afraid of. I shall be with you. It's all in the mind, child.
You can't make me sing. I won't. I won't.
Now we'll have none of that, young lady.
Everyone's here. Have you seen my...
Mummy, please don't make me sing.
She's a little nervous, Mum.
Perfectly natural. I've seen it often.
Alice, you promised me and your father. All the guests are so looking forward to it.
It's expected.
Of course, dear, if you really don't want to, your father and I will understand. They will be very disappointed.
I don't want to disappoint you and Daddy.
Don't worry, darling. I'm sure you'll make us all very proud.
And remember, Alice, whatever happens, flood or earthquake, the show must go on. Cherry ripe, cherry ripe, ripe I cry, fool and fair ones come and
buy. Oh, what am I going to do, Dinah? Not for the songs I have to sing cherry ripe. In front of all these strangers.
Thank you. Oh, 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 dear. Oh, dear. I'll be so late.
And whiskers, look how late it's getting. Oh. Oh, late, late, late.
Perhaps I fell right through the earth and come out the other side. I shall have to ask somebody the name of the country. Please, ma'am, is this New Zealand or Australia? Now that I'm in, how do I get out? There before. I wonder if it's all right to drink. If you drink too much from a bottle marked poison, it's almost certain to disagree with you sooner or later. This bottle's not marked poison.
Thank you.
what am I supposed to do? Curiouser and curiouser. If it makes me grow taller, then I can reach the key. And if it makes me grow smaller, I can creep under the door. Either way, I'll get into the garden.
Absolutely savage if I keep her waiting.
Please, sir, can you help me?
Are you crying?
Yes.
Well, fortunately, I speak both crying and sobbing fluently. But I can't stay. I'm late.
No. Yesterday everything was so normal. Now look at me, I'm huge. And I'm stuck. I wonder what's making me grow smaller. Must be this fan.
Lady.
You did look like a mouse.
I'm late. Come with me. I've a very important lecture to deliver, and everyone will be there. My lectures have to be seen and heard to be depreciated. Of course, they divide people. Last time, the whole audience hissed, all except one man. He was applauding the hissing. What am I going to do? Whatever it is I'll talk about, you can be sure it isn't new. Not new. Not new. I am an English lecturer, the most famous of my time, because I stick with the same old words and never change a line. Not a line. Not a line. No, not a line. My mother couldn't carry a tune, not even if it had handles. Silly old trout. Oh, a most depressing venue. The distemper's coming off of the knees. The audience looked lively enough. That's the main thing. I mean, they're not dead. Yet. What's your name, if it isn't a rude question?
Alice.
Oh, well. That's not your fault.
You're wet.
Sit down. I'll soon make her dry enough. My lecture is the driest thing I've ever heard of. Settle down, everybody, whilst I clear my throat.
Get on with it, walnuts.
Now then. William the Conqueror, whose cause was favoured by the Pope.
Ow! Ow!
Did you speak?
I don't think so.
Edwin and Morcar, the earls of Mercia and Northumbria, declared for him. And even Stigand, the patriotic Archbishop of Canterbury, found it advisable to go with Edgar Atheling to meet William and offer him the crown. How are you getting on now, my dear?
I'm as wet as ever. Doesn't seem to dry me at all.
Are you sure? I don't like the sound of it.
None of us do. In which case, I move the meeting adjourn. Henry, immediately,
if not sooner, adopt more energetic remedies to facilitate a cure for witness, Percy.
Speak English!
What I was going to say was, ipso facto, the best thing to get her dry would be
a caucus race.
What's a caucus race?
A caucus race! A caucus race!
What's a caucus race?
I'll pick a few things.
Now you're talking.
Yes, I am talking. Now what's a caucus race?
The best way to explain a caucus race is to do it. On your marks! Get set!
Extraordinary display of skill, determination, and sheer stupidity.
That's a caucus race!
So perish all enemies of the soul!
No! Just deformed!
No man calls me deformed unless he's sanctified!
Look! Look! The finishing post!
Who's won? Who's won?
I vouchsafe! Did everybody won? Oh. And we must all have prizes! Ah.
Who's going to give the prizes?
Why, Elise, of course.
Oh! I think it's time we were all in bed with a cup of hot chocolate.
Indubitably.
Wait. Where are you all going? Wait.
Duchess, oh my sweet paws, oh my fur and whiskers, she'll get me executed as sure as ferrets are ferrets.
Oh, what have you lost, sir?
A pair of white kid gloves and a fan.
Oh, I'll help you find them.
What are you doing here?
I'm trying to get into the beautiful garden.
Run home and fetch me another pair of gloves and a fan. Quick! Oh!
He's treating me as if I'm his housemaid. Frederick Rabbit's house. Very well for a rabbit. Some of these things must be priceless, or even more expensive. It doesn't say drink me like the other bottle. I'm sure it will make something interesting happen. I just hope it makes me grow large again. Ugh, that's enough.
Window. Pat! Pat!
I'm here, Your Honor. I'm here. I was out the front digging for apples. Oh, for sure. It's a dewy dawn when the lark's on the wing and the snail's on the horn. What?
Oh, not now, Pat. Just help me out of this.
All right, come on. Oh. Oh, no, that won't do the vegetables any good, Your Honor.
Why are we growing cucumbers, Pat?
Because they're green, Your Worship.
I thought so. Now tell me, Pat, what's that in the window?
Let's have a look. Hang on a sec. That's an arm, Your Worship.
An arm? Whoever saw an arm that size?
No one, but sure, it's still an arm.
Well, it's no business there. Remove it.
Me, Your Worship?
Yes, you. Are you a coward?
Ah, no, not at all. I might have coward's legs, but the rest of me's as brave as a lion.
There's nothing to be afraid of.
Well, then you do it.
I'm too rich. I can't afford to die.
Ow! Will somebody please help me? I'm stuck. I'm stuck. Why won't anyone help me? I can't do it by myself.
Why do you keep falling like that, Your Honor?
I like it. Oh, help me up.
Oh, right so. Here, take me right hand. There we go. Oh, no! That's me right hand. Oh. Bill!
Hello.
You're needed, lad.
What's the matter, sir?
Master's got a terrible case of a fall. Oh.
Get a ladder.
Oh. Right. Now be careful with that ladder, lad. You might hit. Oh!
No! Sorry, sir.
Oh. Put the ladder up against the house. Oh. Yes, yes. That's good. Now, climb up.
What for?
You've got to get on the roof, slide down the chimney, and see who's in the house.
Why?
Because I can't get through the door or windows.
No, sir, that's a mighty clever idea. But you see, I've got a bad back for chimneys. I inherited it from my mother. We've always had terrible backs for chimneys.
Oh, you do it, Bill.
Who, me?
Yes, you.
Oh, all right, then.
Quick. Hurry.
Now, careful, Bill. There's a loose slate up there somewhere. Ah, good man.
You found it.
Tell him to climb down the chimney.
Bill!
How?
Climb down the chimney!
His head. Here's brandy.
Ah, thank you, Your Worship.
Not you.
Ah, sorry. Purely medicinal. Runs in the family.
What happened, Bill?
Well, something comes at me. Like a jack-in-the-box. And then up I goes. Like a skyrocket.
Spoken like a true Irishman, Bill.
I don't like the look of this. There's nothing for it. We must burn down the house.
Not taking Your Worship. You'd like me to sing some melodies of old Ireland?
No, just burn down the house.
Oh, no, you don't. You're not burning down this house while I'm inside.
Ah, a barrowful should do.
Ready? Fire!
Stop it! You better not do that again! They're not real pebbles. They're soft like sponges. Go and find that lovely garden. No one will think of looking for me there. Everything seems different from down here. I have to keep looking up. I'm sure little people must get very bad neck strain. It's enough to make a cat bark. When I used to read fairy tales, I never thought I would end up in the middle of one. There ought to be a book written about me. Maybe when I grow up, I'll write one. Sir, who do I have the honor of addressing?
Major Caterpillar, ribbon and bar, late of Her Majesty's foot and light, a true son of England and his flag, what? Who are you?
I don't really know.
If you don't, I don't.
I know who I was this morning, but I think I've been changed several times since then.
Explain yourself, or you'll find yourself on a charge.
Well, I can't explain myself, sir, because I'm not myself, you see.
No, I don't see.
Everyone should be the right size, shouldn't they? But I've been so many different sizes in one day, it's very confusing.
Why?
Well, if you were to change into a butterfly, say, you'd find it quite strange, wouldn't you?
Not a bit of it. Nothing strange to me.
I don't think you should talk to me like that.
Like what?
In short sentences.
Oh.
All I know is that it's very disturbing. Sometimes I start crying.
Why?
Because I don't remember things like I used to. And I can't keep the same size for 10 minutes together.
That's a rum do. I'd keep an eye on it if I were you. Can't remember what things exactly.
Songs and poems.
Scared? It's worse than having the beriberi. Recite! You are old Father William. Stand up, girl. You can't sing or recite without standing up.
Well, that's just it. I don't want to.
No, elbows all wrong. Tuck them in. Tuck them in! Good. Try and keep in tune.
You are old, Father William, the young man said, and your hair has become very white. And yet you incessantly stand on your head. Do you think at your age this is right?
I don't know if you were trying for the Paganini variations for voice and trumpet, but you missed 5 verses.
Some of the words did get a little altered.
Young lady, it was wrong from beginning to end, and you can't get wronger than that.
I'm afraid that's what always happens when I have to perform.
You mustn't be afraid. That's worse than not remembering.
Oh, dear.
What size do you want to be? Speak up! Speak up!
I don't care about the size, just so long as I'm not changing all the time, you know?
No, I don't know.
There you go again with your short sentences.
There you go, losing your temper. It's against Queen's regulations. Do you like your size right now?
I'd like to be a little taller. This is a terrible height to be.
Terrible? Gad, whoa!
One side will make you taller. The other side will make you shorter.
One side of what?
The mushroom. That's what it's there for. Everything has a purpose, even here.
Thank you, Major. One side makes me taller. The other side will make me shorter. I wonder which one is which.
An invitation from the Queen to play croquet.
From the Queen, an invitation for the Duchess to play croquet.
An invitation to play croquet from the Queen for the Duchess.
I've got the gist.
You sure?
Yes, it's an invitation from the Queen for the Duchess to play croquet.
I wouldn't put it quite like that, but I'll have to do, I suppose.
No good you knocking like that.
Why not?
Two good reasons. One, because I'm on the same side of the door as you.
Oh, yes.
Two, they're making so much noise inside, no one can hear you.
But how am I going to get inside?
That is the question. The problem. You might even say the conundrum or riddle.
Yes, I might.
There'd be some sense in you knocking if we had a door between us. I could go and get a spare door, but that would take too long. On the other hand, if you were inside the house, you could knock and I could let you out. Knock, knock. This way out, madame.
But I don't want to go out. I want to go in.
Of course. But if you did want to go out, it would be much easier. Meanwhile, I'm going to sit here until tomorrow. Or the next day, perhaps. Or even for a whole week. Then I can come back by popular demand.
But how am I supposed to get inside? I need to ask them a question.
Will you ever get in is the question you should be asking. I'm going to sit here for days thinking about it and singing Coming Through the Rye.
It's no use talking to you. I'll just have to do it myself.
That's the spirit.
Please, could you tell me why your cat is grinning at me like that?
He's a Cheshire cat. Cheshire cats always grin. Isn't that so, Piggy?
I didn't know Cheshire cats always grinned. In fact, I didn't know cats could grin.
Well, you don't know very much then, do you? Isn't that so, Piggy?
Are you really a duchess?
Every inch.
Hit his poor little nose.
Nonsense! He can already play Three Blind Mice on his nose flute. What do you want, little miss?
I want to know how to get into the garden.
Now you're talking. But I prefer singing to talking, don't you? Get some song. Speak roughly to the little boy and beat him when he sneezes. He only does it to annoy, because he knows it teases. Severely to my boy, I beat him when he sneezes, for he can thoroughly enjoy the purple when he pleases.
out of here. They're sure to kill you.
No! Denver!
I thought you wanted to go in.
I've been in, now I'm coming out.
Life is so complicated.
You mustn't grunt like that. You sound as if you've turned into a pig. If you have turned into a pig, I'd best let you go. When he gets older, he'll make a very ugly child. Or a very handsome pig. Now which way? Ah! Cheshire Puss. Can you tell me which way to go?
Well, that depends on where you want to get to.
The garden.
Why do you want to go there?
It looks safe.
Sometimes things that look safe turn out nasty. And things that look nasty turn out safe. That's a moral.
What sort of people live around here?
Well, a hatter lives over there. Follow my pointing paw. And a gentleman called Hare, nicknamed March, lives there. They're probably having a tea party. They're both mad.
But I don't want to meet mad people.
But you can't help it. Everyone here is mad. I'm mad. You're mad. It's only by chance and careful planning if you're not.
How do you know I'm mad?
Because you're here. And everyone here is mad. I went to a hunt ball once. I didn't like it. Terrible people. They all started hunting me.
Life must be hard for you.
But I grin and bear it. By the by, what became of the baby?
It turned into a pig.
I knew it would. It's the same with crows and moorhens. Did you say pig or fig?
I said pig, and I wish you wouldn't keep appearing and disappearing so suddenly. You're making me very dizzy.
Oh, so sorry. Is this better?
Which way shall you go? Which path shall you take? If you don't take any, you will make a mistake. Which way shall you go? Which path shall you take? You have to move on, though you tremble and quake.
The Cheshire Cat was right. They are having tea. I wonder if they'd mind if I joined them.
Have you any more food down there, Dormy? Any spoilt sandwiches or strawberries? I love strawberries, don't you?
I'm sure he's hoarding them.
I'm lost. Could I get
some... No room! There's no room!
There's plenty of room.
Why didn't you report this sooner, Hattie?
I overslept.
Why are you here?
Well, I've been looking for the pretty garden all day, and now I'm tired and hungry.
Oh, that's different.
We've been eating for hours.
And we're not finished yet.
Waiter, there's a hare in my soup.
Is it blonde? We're missing a waitress.
Have some wine.
I don't see any wine.
There isn't any, and you're too young.
Then it wasn't very nice of you to offer it.
It wasn't very nice of you to sit down without an invitation. This is a private soiree.
Well, I suppose I shouldn't have just barged in. I know I wasn't invited, but the table was laid out for a lot of people.
My response to that is both profound and meaningful. Get your hair cut.
You shouldn't make personal remarks. It's very rude.
I didn't know that. Personal remarks are rude.
Mm-hmm.
Egad, you learn something new every day. Make a note of that, March. It might come in useful. Now, I have one for you.
Ooh.
Why is the raven like a writing desk?
Why is a raven...
I'm not talking to you.
Why not? Aren't I good enough?
You've had it before.
But you were looking at me when you said, why is a raven...
I'm asking Alice!
Why is a raven like a writing desk? You know, I'm pretty sure I can guess.
You mean you think you know the answer?
Yes.
Then you should say what you mean.
Well, I do. At least I mean what I say. That is the same thing.
It's not the same thing at all. You might as well say, I see what I eat. It's the same thing as I eat what I see.
You might as well say, I like what I get, but I get what I like.
You might as well say, I breathe when I sleep. It's the same thing as I sleep when I breathe.
Well, it is the same with you.
Yeah, no. Oh, I need some tea.
Clean cups!
Yeah! Oh, there we go.
Time marches on its stomach!
It's an army that marches on its stomach.
Odd sort of army, marching on its stomach. I don't like the idea. Duck!
What day of the month is it?
The 4th.
Aha! 2 days wrong! I told you not to use butter!
It was the best butter.
Danish.
Some crumbs must have gotten into it as well. I said, don't put butter in the works with a bread knife!
I couldn't put it in with a fork, could I? Here, let me see.
I don't want to give it to you, but I will.
I don't understand it. It was the best butter.
Danish.
It's a funny watch. It tells the day of the month, but not the time.
Why should it? Does your watch tell you what year it is?
No, because it stays a year for so long.
Oh, then I'd rest my case.
Well,
there.
I know when I'm beaten.
Oh, look. Mr. Dormouse is asleep again.
It tells you a lot about your conversation. Sparkle, miss! Sparkle!
Oh, of course, of course. I was just going to say that myself. I'm asleep again.
Have you guessed the riddle about the raven yet?
No, I give up. What's the answer?
I haven't the slightest idea.
Nor me.
I think you should all do something better with the time than wasting it on asking stupid riddles.
If you knew time the way I do, you wouldn't talk about wasting it. Time is a hymn.
It isn't polite.
I don't know what you mean.
Of course you don't. Because you've never spoken to time, have you? Well, I have. We used to be very good friends. We served the Empire in many a distant toast before they all got woodworm. But we... quarreled last March. Just before he went mad.
Flatterer.
It was at the great concert given by the Queen of Hearts.
Quick, stop him! He's going to sing!
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. How terribly sweet of you. Now, for a little bit of encore, I'd like to do a song entitled Auntie's Wooden Leg. Maestro, if you please. Auntie's wooden leg, Auntie's wooden leg. We'll paint it red, call it Fred or Ned or Ted. Oh, Auntie's wooden leg, Auntie's wooden leg. Everybody said it was well and truly dead. Oh, Auntie's wooden leg.
I say.
How dare you interrupt my song with that I say.
I say. In this world, it's not what you know, but who you know.
I don't know either one of them.
Kindly leave the stage by the red door. There's a 50-foot drop on the other side.
But we're still good friends.
No.
Aunties would know.
Auntie's wooden leg. Auntie's wooden leg.
That's enough of that, or she'll walk out.
That's what the audience did at the concert.
Try another song.
We're desperate men.
Twinkle, twinkle, little bat, how I wonder what you're at. Up above the world you fly, like a tea tray in the sky. Twinkle, twinkle, little twinkle, you don't squeak, but solely twinkle, 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 little bee. Twinkle, twinkle, I'm so glad it isn't me.
Lovely, isn't it? It could almost pass for singing.
Twinkle, twinkle, twinkle.
Anyway, I hadn't finished the second verse of the concert when the Queen bawls out, "He's murdering the tune! Off with his head!"
How terrible for you.
You're very understanding for small girl.
Anyway, if you'll pardon the expression, time took offense to our performance.
Your performance.
And ever since then, he won't do a thing we ask. He stopped time.
Could he stop time for me? I have to sing a song.
Wonderful! We're all performers here!
The roar of the grease paint, the smell of the crowd. Nothing like it.
But I don't want to.
Don't want to perform? It's unnatural.
No. Stage fright. I remember my first performance. I shook so much my hat fell off.
If time stopped time for you, he could stop time for me.
But he only stops time at tea time.
So it's always tea time here?
Tell us a story!
I don't know any.
Then Dormy will.
Wake up, Dormy!
I wasn't asleep. Oh, no, I heard every word you fellows said.
Tell us a story.
Please do.
And do it quick, otherwise you'll fall asleep before you've finished it.
Once upon a time, there were three sisters, Elsie, Lacey, and Tilly, and they lived at the bottom of a well.
What did they live on?
What did they live on? Treacle.
That would have made them ill.
It did. It made them very ill.
Have some more tea!
More tea! More tea!
I've had nothing yet, so I can't have any more.
You mean you can't have any less? It's very easy to have more than nothing, especially if you're poor.
I'd still like to know why they lived at the bottom of the well.
Well, it was a treacle well.
A treacle well? There's no such thing.
Disgraceful! You'll hear from my solicitor in the morning.
Outrageous! What about a letter to the Times?
If you can't be civil, you can finish the story yourself.
No, I'm sorry. I won't interrupt you again. I'm sure there's at least one treacle well.
Now, where was I? Oh, yes. So these three sisters were learning to draw.
Draw what?
Treacle.
Hole in one.
I want another clean cup. Everyone, move!
What I don't understand is how they can draw treacle.
You can draw water out of a water well, can't you?
Good one, Hattie, good one!
I don't think I like this tea party as much as I thought I would.
Then you shouldn't talk, just hum. Because we know you socially, Alice, it doesn't mean we're going to introduce you to our friends.
We haven't got any.
But if we had.
If we had.
I'm not staying here listening to you being rude.
You'll find better places for that, I'm sure.
Of course you will, if she's lucky.
Besides, it's going to rain.
It
never rains but it pours.
If it does, we carry on. Little heroes, aren't we, Dormy?
Officer, these men are criminals.
Who's got his ear trumpet?
It's the most stupid tea party I've ever been to.
I told you he wouldn't fit.
Oh, he'll fit. We have to try harder.
I heard that. Try harder.
That's my nose.
That's curious. Things better.
Mr. Five, you're splashing paint.
I couldn't help it, Mr. Two. Mr. Seven dropped my elbow.
Oh, that's right. Shifting the responsibility again.
You can talk. I heard the Queen say you deserve to be beheaded.
What for?
Tulip roots.
What?
For bringing the cook tulip roots instead of onions.
Is that all? That's a mistake anyone can make.
Hello.
Hello.
Why are you painting the roses red?
Well, the fact is, miss, this tree ought by rights to have been a red rose tree, and we planted a white one by mistake.
Easy thing to do.
Yes.
If the Queen was to find out, well, the fact is we'd all have our heads cut off.
So you see, miss, we're doing our best to put things right.
Before she comes.
And who is this?
I agree entirely.
Don't be ridiculous.
Would I lie to you, Your Majesty?
Yes.
Well, thank you. Compliments are always welcome.
You're an idiot.
That's right, Your Majesty. Only you could spot that. It takes one to know one.
A complete idiot. Your name, child?
Alice, if it please Your Majesty.
I be stopped.
And who are these?
How should I know? I'm a stranger here. It's vulgar.
Consider, my dears, he's just a child.
You
think so?
Yes, I would account for it. Children have no respect for their betters these days.
You three, get up! Stop doing that, you're making me dizzy.
What is this?
If it please your majesty, we're trying.
Yes. You are, aren't you? Very trying. Off with their heads.
I won't let you be beheaded. Quick, jumping in. Way I can get an intelligent conversation round here. Can you play croquet? Yes. Come on then!
Nice day.
Very. Where's the Duchess?
Oh, hush, hush. She's due to be executed.
Yes, to your
nobody does if they think they can get away with it. That's a lesson you'll have to learn.
Well, I should have croqueted the Queen's hedgehog, but my hedgehog wouldn't roll into a ball.
Well, you've got to look at it from the hedgehog's point of view.
Yes, I suppose I should have.
How do you like the Queen?
I don't. She's so extremely... likely to win that it's hardly worth finishing the game.
Who are you talking to?
A friend of mine. Cheshire Cat, this is the king.
Oh, I don't like this at all. But as you're in the presence, you may kiss my hand.
I'd rather not.
What? That's rank insubordination. And you know what that leads to. And don't look at me like that.
A cat may look at a king.
What does that mean?
I read it in a book somewhere.
I haven't, but it sounds immoral. It has undertones. That book should be banned.
I like the sound of that.
Ah, my dear. How do we get rid of a floating cat?
Off with its head.
Brilliant! I knew I could rely on you, my dear. I'll just go and fetch the executioner.
Do you know where my hedgehog went?
He rolled away over there.
Now stop it. It's all right. I'm not going to hurt you.
What's necessary is a foot to the back of the neck.
It's difficult. But I must have a ruling. I appeal to you, little girl.
You've still got a little head on your shoulders.
No thanks to you.
What?
I can't hear what you say. One at a time, please.
I'm sorry about my altitude.
It smacks of revolution! You're above us!
My argument is simple and based on irrefutable logic. I'm chief executioner, but I can't cut off an head unless there's a body to cut it from. This here cat hanging up there, large as life and twice as repulsive, has no body. Ipso facto, I cannot separate it from its head.
My argument is, I venture to say, overwhelming. Anything that has a head can be beheaded. And don't forget, I'm also a justice of the peace.
There's too much talk and not enough action. And if something doesn't happen in a minute, I'm going to have everybody executed.
You choose, little girl.
To behead or not to behead, that is the question.
What's the... girl.
You have to tread with care when dealing with cats. They have influence and are seen in all the smart places. You remember the Great Cat Massacre?
Oh, yes. I was forgetting. Catastrophe.
I'd think carefully before acting rashly.
Sound advice, little girl.
And another thing. The cat belongs to the Duchess.
She's in prison. Fetch her!
I remember the Great Cat Massacre of 28. Nasty business.
Yes, it was just after the Great Flamingo Plague of 26, wasn't it?
Ah! Duchess! Think carefully before answering this question. Is this your cat?
No.
No. It isn't? I was told. Ah! It's gone! It's your fault! It was in your custody!
It wasn't official, so it's nothing to do with me, mate. I'm in the clear.
Help me find it! Everybody, help!
Think how glad I am to see you again, you old thing.
Thank you.
You look worried, my dear.
I don't want to go back and sing that song.
The show must go on.
Why?
Life would be very dull if it didn't.
Open your head!
The game's going better now.
And the moral of that is, the more there is of mine, the less there is of yours.
Or you could say, fortune favours the brave.
I could, but I will. Fortune favours the brave. Oh, that's a good moral. You are a clever old thing, you. Oh, it's a fine day, Your Majesty.
I gave you fair warning. Either you or your head must be... Now, my dear, we can finish our game before you leave.
I'm frightened of going back. They want me to do things I don't want to do.
To stay, you have to know the password.
I don't know it.
Guess.
Penny whistle.
Guess again.
Lions and unicorns.
Almost, but not quite. It's honeycomb. Can you write that word down?
Yes.
Blindfolded?
Well...
I thought. Come, come! This won't do! Everybody, please! Off with their heads! Off with their heads! Off with everyone's heads!
This isn't such a lovely garden after all. Now where have I got to? That looks like the coat of arms we have at home.
Hello. Who are you?
Alice.
Alice? That sounds familiar.
And who are you?
A griffin. Part eagle, part lion. The best of each, I always say.
I thought you were a mythical creature.
I am. That makes me even more fascinating.
Is there a way out of this maze, sir?
Let's ask Mr. Mock Turtle. He's my best friend. A splendid fellow. True blue, through and through. Rise and shine, old chum. This is fancy. Who knows what sad thoughts tiptoe through the mossy glades of his mind? I know how to cheer him up. Mockers, tell this young lady about yourself.
She's come to the right person for that. Sit down, both of you.
No thanks, I've heard it all before.
Sit down! It's the least you can do. Once.
I was a real turtle.
Thank you for that very interesting story,
sir. I haven't started yet.
Stay. You may learn something. You must have learned a lot since you've been down here.
Yes, I suppose I have.
When Griff and I were little, we went to school in the same sea. And the master was an old turtle. We used to call him Tortoise.
Why would you call him Tortoise if he wasn't one?
We called him Tortoise because he taught us.
You ought to be ashamed of yourself, asking a simple question like that.
Sheesh. He taught us reeling and riding, and the basic fundamentals of arithmetic, ambition, distraction, uglification, and we also learned drawling. The drawling master was an old conger eel. He taught us drawling, stretching, and fainting in coils.
What?
What was that like?
I'll show you. I'll have it in a minute. I can't show it to you myself. I'm a little too stiff. Old age is not for weaklings. And Griffin here never learned it, did you, Griff?
I didn't have time. I went to the classical master, though. What an old crab he was. Tell her about the games.
You may never have lived in the sea, so you've probably never been introduced to a lobster.
I once tasted a lobster.
You, what?
Nothing.
You've never seen a lobster quadrille, then?
No, what sort of dance is that?
This will give you some idea what it looks like. First, you have to clear away all the jellyfish. You don't want to dance on top of a lot of jellyfish, do you? Yeah.
You have a line of dancers. A turtle, salmon, cod, skate, whoever's available.
And each one has a lobster. Don't forget about the lobster. Yes.
Then you advance twice, change lobsters, and retire in the same order.
Then you throw the lobsters
into the air. Then you change lobsters again.
And that little girl is the first figure of the dance.
It's a beautiful dance.
Oh, it is. And it costs a pretty penny.
And a few ugly ones, too. Now, we'll show it to you. Will you walk a little faster, said a whiting to a snail. There's a porpoise close behind us, and he's treading on my tail. See how eagerly the lobsters and the turtles all advance. They are waiting on the shingle. Will you come and join the dance? See how eagerly the lobsters and the turtles all advance. They are waiting on the shingle. Will you come and join the dance?
Dance.
Will you, won't you, will you, won't you join the dance?
Dance.
Will you, won't you, will you, won't you join the dance?
Dance.
Thank you. It's a very interesting dance to watch.
And no wise fish would ever go anywhere without a porpoise.
Wouldn't it really?
Of course not. Well, if a fish came to me and said he was going on a journey, I'd say, with what porpoise? So you like performing, then?
No, I hate it.
Oh, you mustn't. It's such fun.
Stand up. Oh, you are standing up. Recite, 'tis the voice of the sluggard.
She doesn't know that.
I do.
Recite it, then.
To the voice of a lobster, I heard him declare, you have baked me to a bran and my sugar my hair. As a duck with its eyelids, so he with his nose trims his belt and his buttons and turns out his toes.
You've got it wrong.
I keep getting things wrong today.
I think you'd better sing, turtle soup instead, if you would, old fellow.
You don't have to ask me twice.
He'll sing at the drop of a hat.
I don't have a hat, but if I had and it dropped, I'd sing before it touched the ground.
You're in for a treat, Manish. This man is a master, an undiscovered virtuoso. And he plays the spoons. Show her your reviews.
Later. I'm in my singing mode right now.
Beautiful soup, so rich and green, waiting in a hot tureen. Ooh, for such dainties would not stoop. Soup of the evening, beautiful soup. Soup of the evening, beautiful soup.
Beautiful soup, beautiful soup. Soup of the evening.
Beautiful soup.
Take it, Alice. A little work, but we'll get it.
Beautiful soup, who cares for fish, game, or any other dish? Who would not give all else for two penny worth only of beautiful soup.
Beautiful soup.
Beautiful soup. Soup of the evening.
My dear, I think you're ready to find your way.
And they say this sort of thing is only for the rich. One more chorus, dear fella.
Beautiful soup. Beautiful soup.
Forgetting. Perhaps this is the way out.
Thank you. do you know?
Then I've come to rescue her.
We'll have to fight for her.
You'll observe the rules of battle, of course.
I always do.
You're a worthy opponent, sir.
Another day, perhaps.
Another day, sir.
Yes. Oh.
Victory, wasn't it? As an encore, I do the Battle of Agincourt.
Here, let me help you take your helmet off.
Yes. You're admiring my box. It's my own invention to keep sandwiches in. You see, I carry it upside down so they don't get wet when it rains.
But they can drop out. The lid is open.
So that's what happened to my sandwiches. Now a bee's nest. I should be getting some honey very soon.
But you already have a beehive.
Oh, one of the best. But the bees won't come near it. Same with this. It's a better mousetrap. Come to think of it, I shouldn't be surprised if the mice don't keep the bees out. Well, the bees keep the mice out. One or the other.
But why would you need a mousetrap? You won't find many mice running around on the backs of horses.
But if there were, he'd be protected, wouldn't you, old chap?
Are you all right?
I hope you've got your hair fastened on tight.
Only in the usual way.
Well, that's not good enough. The wind is as strong as soup around here. You must be ready for anything, and nothing can frighten you.
Have much riding practice. Oh,
what makes you say that?
You keep falling off your horse.
I've had plenty of practice at that. Plenty of practice.
Yes, I suppose you have.
The art of riding is to keep your balance. Hold this.
What is it?
I forget, but I know it was a bargain. Plenty of practice. Plenty of practice. Driven by a lake.
when you're like this?
Like what?
Head downwards and body in the air.
What does it matter where my body happens to be? My mind goes on working just the same. It's a hive of activity. Ideas. In fact, the more head downwards I am, the more I keep inventing things. The cleverest thing I ever invented, I thought of head downwards.
And what was that?
A new pudding. Come to think of it, I don't believe that pudding was ever cooked.
Why? What was it made of?
Rotting paper.
Ugh, that wouldn't have been very nice.
Not very nice alone, but mixing it with other things like gunpowder and sealing wax gives it a true taste of the Cordon Blues. Now I must leave you. I've still dragons to slay and young ladies to rescue. You look worried. You're too young to worry. Look at me. I don't worry.
Well, I was thinking about the things I have to do when I go home.
You're going home?
I don't want to, but perhaps I should.
Just be brave and always get back on your horse. Keep your balance all the time. Yes, yes.
Can you tell me how to get out of the forest?
Plenty of practice, but...
Ah! Before you go!
Just be brave!
Mr. Knight! Tiger Lily,
I wish you could talk so you could tell me how to get out of this wood.
I can talk. When there's anybody worth talking to.
Can all flowers talk?
As well as you?
Oh, it isn't manners for us to speak first. We were wondering if you'd speak.
I thought your face had got some sense on it. Not much, but some.
But the colouring's right.
Oh, I don't care about her colour. If only her petals curled more, she'd be all right.
Aren't you frightened of growing out here, with no one to look after you?
There are plenty of trees. What else are they good for?
What good are trees when danger comes near?
They have a good bark.
Silence, all of you. They're only like that because I can't get at them. They're too close to the ground.
If you're not polite, I'll make you into a chain.
Daisies are worst of all, next to snapdragons.
How is it that all of you can talk so well? I've been in lots of gardens and I've never heard flowers talk before.
Feel the ground.
It's very hard.
Ah. In most gardens, the flower beds are too soft. So the flowers are always asleep.
I see. I never thought of that.
In my opinion, I doubt if you ever think at all.
Hold your tongue. All of you.
Now, which way out of the wood?
That way.
That way.
Yeah, this way. That way.
Definitely that way.
That way.
That way.
Standing still as waxworks.
And if you think we're waxworks, you should pay for the privilege of looking. Waxworks aren't made to be looked at for nothing.
Know-how. Contrary-wise, if you think we're alive, we ought to introduce ourselves.
I am Mr. Tweedledum, and this is Mr. Tweedledee.
I'm Alice.
Does the name Veronica Bott mean anything to you?
No, who is she?
I don't know, but we're obviously doing her a favor mentioning her.
Do you think she'll be grateful if she becomes famous? No! How?
I was just thinking of that poem of you two. Tweedledum and Tweedledee agreed to have a battle, for Tweedledum, said Tweedledee, had spoiled his nice new rattle. Just then flew down a monstrous crow as black as a tar barrel, which frightened both the heroes so they quite forgot their quarrel.
There's no monstrous crow.
You recited that poem very nicely. Congratulations. But it isn't us. No, no. It's another set of Tweedledums and Tweedledees altogether. Completely different people. But the names are the same.
Contrary-wise, you began all wrong.
Yes, yes. After you said, I am Alice, you should have said, how doody, and shake hands.
Ta-da!
Now, shake.
Here we go round the mulberry bush, the mulberry bush, the mulberry bush. Here we go round the mulberry bush on a cold and frosty morning.
Twice round's enough for any dance.
I hope you're not too tired.
No way, no way. Thank you for asking.
As we began with poetry and song, let's continue that way.
I'm sorry. I haven't the time.
Neither have we. We never carry a watch.
No how.
The poem's called The Walrus and the Carpenter. You'll love it.
Ta-da!
You start, Brother Mime. The sun was shining on the sea. The sun was shining on the sea, shining with all his might. He did his very best to make the billows smooth and bright. And this was odd because it was the middle of the night.
The walrus and the carpenter were walking close at hand. They worked like anything to see such quantities of sand.
If this were only cleared away, it really would be grand. If seven maids with seven mops swept for half a year, do you suppose that they could get it clear? I doubt it very much.
And he shed a bitter tear.
Sorry.
Hello.
Oh, oysters. Will you walk with us?
The walrus did beseech.
A pleasant walk, a pleasant talk along the briny beach. But we cannot do with more than four to give a hand to each.
The eldest oyster looked at him, but never a word he said. Meaning to say he did not choose to leave the oyster bed.
But four young oysters hurried out. All eager for the treat. Their coats were brushed, their faces washed, their shoes were clean and neat, and this was odd.
And why was that?
Because they hadn't any feet.
The time has come,
the walrus said,
to talk of many things, of shoes and ships and sealing wax, of cabbages and kings, and why they're sea is boiling hot, and whether pigs have wheatens.
Wait a bit,
the oysters cried.
Before we have our chat, for some of us are out of breath, and all of us are fat.
There really is no hurry.
We thank you very much for that.
A slice of bread is what we chiefly need. Pepper and vinegar besides are very good indeed. So if you're ready, oysters, dear, we can begin to feed.
But not on us, not on us. See, we're turning a little blue after such kindness that would be a dismal thing. thing to do.
Yes, it was very kind of you to come. And you're very nice.
Give us another slice, my friend. Huh? Give us another slice. I wish you were not quite so deaf. I've had to ask you twice.
Well, it seems a shame, I must confess, to play them such a trick when we brought them so far and made them trot so quick.
Look at this. Look at this. The butter's spread too thick.
I weep for you. I really do. I deeply sympathize.
With sobs and tears, he sorted out those of the largest size, holding his pocket handkerchief before his streaming eyes.
Oh, oysters, I have to say, you've had a pleasant run. Shall we be trotting home again?
But answer came there none.
And this was scarcely odd because
they'd eaten every one.
Oh, woeful weeping walrus, your tears are all a sham. You're greedier for oysters than children are for jam.
So, what's the verdict?
I like the walrus best, because he did feel a little sorry for the oysters.
Chaw! He ate more than Carpenter.
In that case, I like the Carpenter better, if he didn't eat as many as the walrus.
Ate as many as he could get.
Then they're both very nasty characters.
Duh. Oh!
What is it?
It was the Red King snoring.
Yes, it's the King of Hearts' lazy, no-good brother. Every family has one.
Except ours.
We've got two. Come, let's have a look at him.
He's dreaming about you. You're only a sort of thing in his dream.
Yes, he woke up now. You go up. Puff.
I would not. Besides, if I'm only a sort of thing in his dream, then what are you two? I'm going.
Well, all's well that ends well. What is this?
It's your rattle.
You left it in the grass.
Looks a bit battered.
It's spoiled.
Don't get so upset about an old rattle.
Old? It isn't old. I bought it yesterday. It's brand spanking new. There's only one thing for it.
Get a new one?
No, nothing so simple. No, no. No, we have to fight for the honor of the Tweedles. Right. Ned Tweedledum versus the superior strength and skill of Fred Tweedledee. Frankly, it's a bit one-sided. I don't know. I was an advisor to the British Army.
I advised them not to take him, but they wouldn't listen.
This is fighting talk. So is this. She must help us dress for it. Armor to protect our vital parts.
Whatever the outcome, dear brother, I shall remember you in my will.
No money, of course, but I shall write, I remember you, Fred.
I appreciate the thought, but I'd rather have the cash, Ned.
Why are you only wearing one sock?
I'm trying to save money.
Do I look pale?
A little.
Generally, of course, I'm very brave, but today I have a headache.
And I've got a toothache, which makes us even.
You'd better not fight today, then.
Oh, well, we must have a bit of a fight. It's expected.
And all because of a rattle.
Yes, well, I wouldn't have minded, but it was brand new.
seems a bit petty.
Yes, indeedy. That's exactly why it's so important.
You are hereby and forthwith summoned to attend the trial of Sir Jack, the Knave of Hearts.
Soprano sex.
What are they doing? They can't have anything to write. The trial hasn't begun yet.
They're putting down their own names in case they forget them by the time the trial is over.
Stupid.
How do you spell stupid?
What's after tea?
Dinner. Is it dinner time? It's dinner time.
Oh, it's dinner time.
No, it isn't.
Oh, it was dinner time. My stomach feels like my throat. Nexus.
Cedric, you're too easy. Chop off more heads. It's wonderful. Chop, chop. There's blood everywhere. Makes you proud to be queen.
You missed.
Oh, it did? Never mind, I felt it anyway.
I'm not going to be called, am I?
Called what?
I don't want to stand up in front of all these people. Why am I here?
To save Jack from a death worse than fate.
Clerk of the court, read the accusation.
The Queen of Hearts, she made some tarts, all on a summer day. The Knave of Hearts, he stole those tarts and took them right away.
Oh, I confess, I didn't do it. And I'm glad I didn't do it. And if I had my time again, I probably still wouldn't do it.
Bang! Open and shut case.
That can't be right.
Did you say something, Alice?
No.
Glad that's over. Members of the jury,
12 good pigs and true. You must retire and consider your verdict.
Not yet.
Why not?
There's a great deal more to come before you can say that.
That's odd, not to say strange.
Gentlemen of the jury, it is obvious the accused is guilty. Put aside the evidence and look at his face. It is the face of a habitual criminal. A hardened felon, a recalcitrant rogue. What is it?
Where's lawyers for the defense?
Oh, I rest my case.
Call the first witness.
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 Good day.
Snap! I'm sorry about bringing these things in with me, but I hadn't quite finished my tea when I was sent for.
He never finishes his tea.
It isn't healthy. All those cucumber sandwiches. Look at his legs.
I can't. Oh,
that's what I mean. He's got a case of cucumber legs. The worst I've ever seen. And I've seen a few in my time.
Well, you're a fine one to talk, Tubby.
You ought to have finished tea. What time did you start?
I'll have to ask Mr. Hare.
Send for...
I didn't finish the sentence.
But you haven't passed one yet, Your Majesty.
Oh, that's right.
When did we start tea? 14th, wasn't it?
Yeah, 15th.
16th.
Write that down.
Right.
14, 15 and 16. 14, 15 and 16. Now, subtract... multiply and convert to grams and kilos. What's the answer?
Sled.
They should be able to do it in their heads.
Off with them.
That hat! Disrespect to this court. Take it off.
And his head with it.
I can't. Your Honor.
Why can't you take it off, pray?
It isn't mine.
Stolen. Members of the jury, write that down. Stolen hat one. This man is a self-confessed thief. And he has the gall to come into this court as a character witness.
The king seems very prejudiced.
Oh, thank you, Alice. That's what makes me so eminently qualified to be a judge.
Oh, yes.
Don't I know you?
Oh, I shall have... none of my own. I'm a hatter.
Then why didn't you say so? That's the first thing you should have said. Now, give us your evidence. Don't be nervous.
Oh, no.
Or we'll execute you on the spot.
I'm not nervous. I've nothing to hide. Done my duty. Served my country.
I do know you.
Oh! Didn't we meet in Biarritz in the summer of 41, or was it Heidelberg?
Hatter, your evidence.
He's just making him more nervous. Stay calm, Mr. Hatter.
I'm a poor man, Your Honor, and I haven't had my tea. And what with the sandwiches getting ruined after being eaten once, and the twinkling of the teacups.
Twinkling?
You're the twinkler! I remember you sang at my concert! Twinkle, twinkle, little!
Twinkle, twinkle, little gnat, how I wonder what you're at. You are very small indeed, you can vanish up my sleeve. Up my sleeve, up my sleeve, you can vanish up my sleeve.
Do uncles, but we're available for weddings and funerals.
You did sing at my concert, but this was even worse.
I've been practicing.
Oh, it's an offense against all we held dear. Cedric, this man ruined my concert just as he's ruining your trial.
Oh, poor man. I stand before you full of remorse and malnutrition. When Mr. Marchare said,
I deny it.
I object.
Objection denied.
Ask Dormouse.
Ask Dormouse what?
I can't remember.
You must remember, or I'll have you executed.
Stand your ground, Mr. Hatter.
I'm a very poor man, Your Majesty.
And a very poor actor. Suppress that cheering. If that's all you know, you may stand down.
Well, I can't get down any lower. I'm on the floor as it is.
You may go.
Would you like another course of Twinkle?
Go! Oh! Take off his head outside.
Call the next witness.
What about me?
What about you?
I'm the accused. All you do is call witnesses. It's not fair. I should have the most important part here. I haven't said a word for pages and pages.
What did you want to say?
I'd just like you to know that I have no need to steal. I'm independently wealthy. I have all the money I'll need for the rest of my life. Provided I die by 1 a.m. tomorrow morning.
We'll try and arrange it.
Oh, well, that's all right then.
Jack's an idiot.
He's your nephew.
Only on my father's side.
That's my cook. How dare she?
Give your evidence.
Chant.
Oh dear.
Chant.
Chant. Chant.
What now?
Your worship must cross-examine the witness.
Oh, must I?
Be a man, Cedric.
Be a man.
Oh, very well. What are the tarts made of?
Yeah. What about repeating the question, Cain Sarr?
I recognise your accent. Girton College?
No, I went to Oxford, Mrs.
You poor devil. And what did you study?
Oh, to speak like this.
The witness will answer the question. What are the tarts made of?
Pepper, mostly.
Treacle.
What did he say?
Treacle.
That's Mr. Dormouse. He's no right to be here. Off with his whiskers.
Call the next witness.
Call Alice.
What's the matter, Alice?
I don't like being called up here like this.
I should like it if it happened to me.
Yes, most people like being the center of attention. Now, what do you know about this business with the tarts?
Nothing whatsoever.
Oh, that's very important.
Unimportant, Your Majesty.
Unimportant, of course, is what I mean to say. Unimportant. Unimportant. Important. Unimportant.
I've told you all I know. I'd like to go back to my seat now.
We're moved by your plea, but I'm reminded of Rule 42. All persons more than a mile high have to leave Wonderland.
I'm not a mile high.
You are.
More like 2 miles high.
You just invented that rule.
It's the oldest rule in the book.
Then it should be rule number one.
Careful, Cedric. They're taking over the court. Especially that girl. Punish somebody.
You've too much to say for yourself, Alice. Jury, consider your verdict.
No! Sentence? Far
just verdict after.
That's stupid.
Have a care, Alice.
I can't let you condemn an innocent man.
Why not? It happens all the time.
Off with her!
Don't keep shouting off with her head in case someone shouts off with yours.
You've lost your last chance of staying here. It's back to the real world for you, young lady.
I don't care. All the tarts are here, so how could the prisoner have stolen them? There is no crime.
Alice, don't you care what people think?
Not when I'm right.
Are you so confident, young lady?
Yes, I am. Yes, I am confident.
Then you don't need us anymore.
Daughter Alice is going to sing for us.
It's cherry ripe, isn't it, dear?
Walk a little faster, said a whiting to a snail.
Are you sure, dear?
Yes, I'm sure.
Will you walk a little faster, said a whiting to a snail. There's a porpoise close behind us and he's treading on my tail. See how eagerly the lobster and the turtles all advance. They are waiting on the shingle. Will you come and join the dance? Will you, won't you, will you, won't you join the dance? Will you, won't you, will you, won't you join the dance? Will you, won't you, will you, won't you join the dance?
Thank you.
From the creators of Gulliver's Travels and Merlin comes the biggest entertainment event of the year. Alice in Wonderland.
I'll be so late.
Discover a masterpiece of imagination starring Robbie Coltrane, Whoopi Goldberg, Ben Kingsley, Christopher Lloyd, Miranda Richardson, Martin Short, Peter Ustinov, George Wendt, Gene Wilder, and Tina Majorino as Alice. Vivid storybook characters come to life with spectacular special effects.
Would somebody please help me?
No! We've been eating for hours.
We're not finished yet.
If you want to experience something altogether different, you've come to the right place. This is not your ordinary tea party.
What sort of people live around here?
Everyone here is mad.